Need for Speed Payback Improved in almost every way. About 2 years ago, Ghost Games and EA Games released a reboot of the Need for Speed series with a title of the same name. It borrowed heavily from the Need for Speed Underground and Most Wanted games, featuring an open world, deep customization, police chases, and arcade handling, while adding a dose of current car culture with various automotive heroes, that is Ken Block, Magnus Walker, etc. Overall, it was plenty of fun, but had a large number of quirks, such as a lack of manual transmission, an online requirement even when playing solo, and a rough physics engine. Now we get our hands on the game's successor, Need for Speed Payback. Though the premise and setting are new, it is very much a continuation of the previous game in spirit, one with many improvements, but a few new issues. Let's start with the improvements. One of the most obvious is the better handling system. In the previous game, cars felt quite stiff and prone to understeer. Front drive cars were especially bad in this regard. And when the cars weren't plowing forward, they snapped into wild smoky drifts. This would have been alright, but it was usually necessary for navigating turns and often scrubbed off too much precious speed. In Need for Speed Payback, this driving method has been thoroughly refined. Cars can turn tighter and more responsively while maintaining grip. They still understeer a bit more than we'd like, but it's much better. And the drifting that's often necessary no longer seems to scrub off much, if any, speed. The updated physics are also complemented by a map that supports the way the cars drive. Roads are extremely wide and frequently have a lot of runoff, making it so that you won't be crashing and riding walls as much. Another noteworthy improvement to the driving experience is a manual shifting option right from the get-go. Thankfully, it also doesn't require using the right analog stick, as the previous game required in an update. Another major improvement is in the number of cars and visual customization. As mentioned previously, the car list in Payback isn't massive, but it does manage to hit highlights from every genre of automobile, and the list has expanded from the previous game. There are some odd absences, such as a complete lack of road-going Toyotas. Forza Motorsport 7 has the same issue, and no current WRX or Type R, but they aren't deal-breakers. The visual customization, as deep as it was last time, is even deeper now. Nearly every car can have nearly every part tweaked, including lights, bumpers, mirrors, fenders, hoods, trunks and wheels. There are some new vanity parts available, such as different colored tire smoke, nitrous flames and underglow.